واذكر في الكتاب إدريس إنه كان صديقا نبيا ورفعناه مكانا عليا.
The story of Idris عليه الصلاة والسلام, known as Enoch, may peace be upon him, in the English language. Where exactly does he fit in? The majority of the historians say that he was one of the great grandchildren of Adam alayhi salatu wassalam. So when Adam alayhi salatu wassalam was 840 years old, this is when he was born. And then they say that he was a man who was tall, he was very good looking, he was very calm, he had a full grown beard. Subhanallah. And he spoke very, very clearly. When he spoke, he was calm. When he walked, he lowered his gaze and looked on the ground. And he was a very collected individual, calm and collected. And he used to ponder and reflect. And he used to advise with so much goodness. That was Idris alayhi salatu wasalam. So what does the Quran make mention of this prophet? There are only two verses that we find in the Quran regarding the prophet Idris alayhi salatu wasalam. So this now we know confirmed. He was truthful and he was a prophet. The quality of truthfulness. So, if you look at the Mufassireen, they make mention of the meaning of a high level. If I were to ask you, someone is raised on a high level, what would you say? You would say that spiritually they are elevated. So the same with Idris alayhi salatu wasalam. He was elevated to a very high level by Allah, in that he was granted nubuwa and he was praised by Allah. And he is mentioned in the Quran, that is a high level. In fact, in another place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وإسماعيل وإدريس وذا الكفل. Three names together. إسماعيل, إدريس and ذا الكفل. May Allah's peace be upon them. كل من الصابرين وأدخلناهم في رحمتنا إنهم من الصالحين. All three of them were very patient. So this is another quality of Idris. He was very patient. And Allah says, and we have granted them from our mercy. We have made them enter into our mercy. We have put them within our mercy. So that is another quality. Allah has had mercy on them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُلُّم مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. They were all pious people, good people. Salih means a pious person. So these are the qualities of Idris alayhi salatu wasalam. We know, and this is definitely a very high status. However, we have a very interesting Israeli riwaya, a narration of the people of the book, which we say, Wallahu A'lam, Allah knows best, but it's interesting to mention it because most books of tafsir have made mention of this beautiful incident. They say Idris alayhi salam, he was told by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, oh Idris, from those who have followed you, anyone who does good deeds, at the end of the day, you will have all those good deeds doubled for yourself. Now that is something amazing. This is a status. Imagine others do good deeds and you getting the reward of it doubled. So he was very happy and he knew that his death was approaching. So he had a friend from the angels and he spoke to this friend. He says, you know, Allah has promised me this reward and I'd like to amass a lot of reward before I go. So why don't we speak to the angel of death? Let's see what he has to say. To say, look, just try and see if you can seek permission to prolong a little bit. So the angel says, look, that is a matter that is decreed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, there's no harm in trying. Come, you ride on my wing and let's go. Subhanallah. So he rode on the wing and he was taken up to the heavens. He crossed the first heaven. He crossed the second heaven. He crossed the third heaven. When he got to the fourth heaven, Allah had instructed the angel of death to take the soul of Idris alayhi salam on the fourth heaven. And the angel of death was following the instruction of Allah, but obviously did not know what was about to happen. When he got to the fourth heaven, he seen Idris there. Amazing. When he seen Idris there, the question was posed that, look, I would like to extend, and so on. He says, look, Allah has already instructed me to take your ruh away. Is it okay? He says, well, if that's the case, it's fine. So it is narrated, Wallahu A'lam, Allah knows best, that his ruh was taken away whilst he was still in the fourth heaven. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam confirms in Sahih al-Bukhari, in an authentic narration that when he went up for Mi'raj, he met Idris alayhi salam in the fourth heaven. So that is a confirmed narration that we know. It's actually hair-raising, as we say. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. That is as much as we know about the life of Idris alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is why some of the mufassirin say, when Allah says he raised him to a high level, he is speaking of literally, Allah took him up physically to the top, and then his soul was taken there.